Today on the Play Guitar Podcast is part two of my mini series all about how to get different guitar tones for different styles of music. I walk through the process of getting the right blues tones and use them in a small recording session. So stay tuned. Welcome to part two. I'm Lee, and I'm very excited to go through some of these blues tones with you today. Let's talk about blues tones. Way back on episode 22, I went in depth on blues gear. We talked about the different amps and guitars and pedals that were common to blues guitarists. There was a lot of information in that. If you're able to access all of that gear, you're very lucky. Sadly for the rest of us, that's not an option. We're going to have to do some generalizing. Basically, if you boil down that whole episode, you come up with these conclusions: Fender amps and all of their different stages and different combinations, they're a staple in blues music. And while there's a big difference between all the different Fender amps, they all have that Fender clean sound. That's their core. That's the key to this. So today I'm going to put that into practice using a Fender amp in a lot of different ways to get some really good blues tones. The Strat, the Telecaster, the Les Paul, and the Gibson 335, they're all very common to blues music. Today I'm going to use a single coil Strat and a humbucker equipped Les Paul and use them to fill out our sounds in a lot of different ways. So I'll also use several pedals to get different sounds out of that Fender amp today as well. So let's talk about the gear. The amp is a homemade Vibralux. I made it a while ago. It uses two 10-inch speakers, and it's based on the Fender Blackface Vibralux circuit. It's got a sparkling, clean sound at low volumes, and as you turn it up, you start to get that classic Blackface breakup. It's around 4 on the dial where it starts. It's a great amp to play live. It's not heavy to carry, and it's more than loud enough to keep up with a very heavy-handed drummer. I also have my 2001 Fender American Double Fat Strat that's been converted to single coil. I've got Fralin pickups in it, the vintage hot in the neck, in the middle, and in the bridge I use the SP43. It's a hotter ceramic Strat pickup. It sounds very close to a P90. I love it in there. So I'm also using the Gibson Les Paul Special HB. It's not such an expensive Gibson, but it's a terrific guitar. Being that it's a special, it doesn't have the carved maple top that makes the guitar lighter and a bit darker sounding, which is something that I like a lot. And the pickups I'm using are DiMarzio 36th Anniversary humbucker pickups. It's a very, very nice PAF type sound. I'm also going to be using these pedals: an Exotic EP booster to boost the signal, a Ibanez TS9 tube screamer for a classic blues lead tone, and a BB preamp, Exotic BB preamp, and also a Maxon SD9, both of those for different types of overdrive. I'm also going to use a little tiny bit of a Boss DD3 delay and a Digitech RV7 reverb. I'm going to use them sparingly to fill out the sound. Okay, so let's take a listen to a bit of the background track before we start adding things. Okay, so let's talk about the tracks. I'm going to record, or I have recorded, 4 tracks. And please remember that none of this is really mixed. This is just some rough mixes just to demonstrate some of this classic gear in some different styles. I haven't added any extra reverb or EQ or compression in my digital audio workstation. This is just raw, and I made all of this up pretty much on the spot, and I'm just putting the playing up, warts and all, to help. So the point of this isn't perfection. It's so you can hear the tones that I'm getting for both of for this blues music and the rock one that's going to be in our next video. So let's take a look at the actual recording of these tones. The first one is going to be a Strat rhythm guitar. It's my Fender Strat on the neck pickup with the Vibralux amp, and the amp's going to be cranked pretty high with no pedals. I'm going to have the volume on 5. At that point, you're starting to get a little bit of breakup. I have the treble all the way up on this to compensate for my isolation cabinet. I'm using a little Axtrax speaker isolation cabinet. It's basically a small speaker with a microphone inside. It's in a closed cabinet, and I'm using that to help keep the neighbors happy. Okay, so let's take a listen to that. All right, so next is another Strat Rhythm. I'm using pedals this time into it, and I'm having the Vibralux in it clean, not so turned up so much, and mic'd with a Shure SM57. The pedals I'm using an exotic EP booster, which is just to boost the signal up a little bit. And then I'm using an exotic BB preamp for the overdrive, and it's set for a light amount of overdrive. But pay special attention to the difference in the overdrive between the two rhythm tracks. The first one's going to be on the left, and the one I'm just doing now is going to be on the right. Okay, let's take a listen to that. Can you tell the difference between the amp drive and the pedal drive? They're pretty close, but I can definitely tell it's definitely a different texture, which helps fill the sound out pretty well. Let's move on to the next one. We're moving on to the lead, the guitar lead. It's a lead track using the Strat Bridge humbucker. The Strat Bridge single coil with a TS9 tube screamer. And that's kind of boosting into the BB preamp, which has a little bit more gain on it. It's got a light gain, but a little bit more, and also using my Boss DD3 delay and the Digitech RV7 reverb. Let's take a listen to that. And for my last track, I wanted to get a little bit different tone. So I'm going to take the middle of that last solo out, and I'm going to add a Les Paul Special HB on the bridge pickup into a BB preamp. And I've turned the gain up a little bit just to give a little bit different sound on that with still the light delay and the reverb. Let's take a listen to that right now. So there it is, a short blues track using some classic gear to get tones that are appropriate for this blues tune. That was a lot of fun. In the last video of this series, I'll do the same process we did today, only with a different style of music. We'll be using rock music this time. I'll take a basic rock background track, I'll make my choices on tones that are appropriate for that style, and record them and show you how I did it. But before we move on to that video, I want to remind you about my free video lesson. It's called Get Your Blues Soloing Under Control. It's the 6 steps I found that'll give you the right foundations for playing killer blues solos in no time at all. It's a lesson I put together after getting together with some of the listeners and really spending some time with them and figuring out what could help them the most at this time. I know it can really help take your soloing in a new direction, and you can click the link below, or an even easier way is just go to freebluesLesson.com. When you sign up for this, you also get news about all my podcasts, videos, and all my other free stuff sent right to your inbox. Okay, thank you so much for joining me today, and let's move on to part 3 and start finding some rock tones.